Well, we haven't had the greatest of days so far. Atta girl. Down the hatch.
And fourth thing is we broke the header, so.
They don't look as bad when they're all on the ground. Don't tell anyone I do this. Good morning. We are finally back in the fields again today. So Mark just took off with combine, Jess followed behind with the buggy, and I am once again on wagon duty.
Quiet, copyright.
Oh, there's my sunglasses. I just went out to the barn to check on that ewe. I got her out this morning.
She's up, but barely. Gotta get this leg a little stronger. Get this up.
I have to work on her front right leg. It's the one that's really lacking some strength. She's kind of like knuckling over. I'm just treating her like a down ewe. I'm treating her kind of like I would treat one with preg tox. So I give her some calcium and I gave her some glycol just for some added sugars, basically glucose. So hopefully that'll help. Her eyes are a lot brighter. She looks a lot more hydrated, which I was really worried that first day. She was looking pretty tough. Anyway, gotta get going. Well, we haven't had the greatest of days so far. Not very productive. Our generator keeps doing some crazy things. So first thing this morning, it just shut down for no apparent reason. He thought it was a wiring glitch. And it just shut down again, and I had to grab Mark from the field again, and he said it overheated. So I'm not sure if it's because it got warm all of a sudden. It's like, well, you can tell with all the flies in my window. And we had another little interruption, but it was a good one. We bought a bin.
You grab an impact. If, oh, I knew that one's coming.
Ken. Do you want me to get some room? Oh, you got shower towels here.
Yeah, they're stripping. Can you get a pair of vice grips and a 3/4 or 9/16 wrench, please?
Sound really good? Sound good at all. Legs plugged. So Mark is not happy.
Yeah, the slides, these ones just get jammed off.
Aeration.
Generator started, can you check?
I can hear this fan, Mark. Or is
the
it
fan
not on?
That's around the generator.
All right, guys, we're cruising right along. The leg needed drained out. It wouldn't start. It was pretty full when the generator quit on us. On a better note, corn's much drier today. We've been in and around 23.5% moisture. That's the lowest it's been thus far. The bad news is this field did not have a fun spring. It was really wet. We were late getting the corn planted in there, and then the drought just hit it at a really, really bad time, and it looked terrible. So yeah, this is the field that Mark's like, that field does have potential to be a very high yielding field. Again, we got a couple big pockets of drainage issues. And even with all the stuff we're doing to reduce compaction and stuff, we've had a few rough winters getting crops off, and it's just added up to some bad drainage. Always some good with some bad. Our new bin, I should just explain what that's for. We are hoping to use that for all our crops that are a little bit different, don't really fit into our system. So all these crops we're kind of experimenting with. So like this year we're gonna put, we still have canola in some wagons, so we got that bin for canola, but we didn't get it till now. I think Mark ordered it in July. My wagon is almost empty, so I better run.
Okay guys, it's been a while. Yes, I cut my hair. It's not that short. It's like that. Anyways. It's been a while. It's now like 4:30, I think. Yeah, something like that. And yeah, everything's going pretty smooth. We had a few hiccups with the leg and the dryer and all that stuff, which I think Mom filmed for you guys. But since then, it's been going pretty good, which is good. I don't know how much more we have here. Not probably too much. And then I think we're gonna do some ripping, and I think Dad might try to spray, but it seems kind of windy still, so I don't know what his plan is. But if he sprays, then I'll end up ripping. If he doesn't spray, then he'll rip. So either way, ripping's gonna get done. Spraying is on the tables. It's going good.
Good morning. Look, no toque, no mitts. Feels like summer again. Well, kind of. Back of corn. Sorry, I just kind of took off yesterday without really finishing off the video, but we finished kind of at dark and we were all a little bit tired. Mark went back out in the field and did some tillage. I don't even want to say it because yesterday I said, oh, we've got a good stretch here. We should be done corn. And everything blew apart. Like, it was such a bad day yesterday. Poor Mark.
Okay, I'm just going to grab my calcium. I've got my syringes in here already from yesterday. Calcium and glycol. So let's take that for now. I do love my very organized shelf. I can't believe it stayed organized all the way through lambing and into now. That never happens. It's usually a mess by now, but the baskets make a big difference, I have to say.
Hello, lady. Looking a little better. Let's see your eyes. Hey.
Oh.
A little better. You can't really tell on camera. Hey.
Let's see if she'll stand up for me. So, whoop, she's peeing. That's good. See this front leg. Oh, that's better than yesterday. That's a girl. That's a girl. Every day is a little better. All right, let's get you treated, honey. Good girl. Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna treat her with some glycol. So it's just sugar, basically, glucose. And some calcium, just to regain some strength. All right, and this is just drenching, so orally.
It's good, it tastes like Kool-Aid.
She doesn't believe me. All right. Atta girl. Down the hatch. Alright, that's done. Now the calcium I have to put over a few spots on her back sub-Q, so I kind of tent up the skin. Okay, if you guys can see, so I'm just going to pull up some skin, put about 10 mil in each little spot. Try to use a really sharp needle so they don't feel it as much. So you can tell she's had an infection. because her wool is like pulling out really easy. She is on her leg.
Easier to do when you're laying down. Hi, Bella.
All right, so that's done. It's like Advil for sheep or animals.
Hi.
We are evaluating our ground conditions because, of course, where I was loading yesterday, they decided to take the grader down that side road. So it's going to be a bit soft for wagons. So we're going to see if we can get them in and out of this field.
She's go time. Let's go, boys. Get this corn situation over with. Okay. I got my snacks. I am, in fact, that person that packs an entire bag of snacks and eats them all in the first 20 minutes, but it do be like that sometimes. Get my iPad started. Shut it. I love technology. See if my camera will work today. Because it wasn't working yesterday and I'm really sad about it. So like I actually had to do like the normal buggy things where you like one back. No. I don't like that. Yeah! Boys, we got the camera back! Oh my god, that is my genuine reaction with my camera. I love that thing so much. Okay, I'm gonna go. Bye.
Just running the combine here today. It's a beautiful day though. I think it's supposed to be 15 or 16 degrees Celsius. And we're in the third last field of corn to harvest. We have this farm that we'll finish up today. And then we have another 100 acres to do on one farm, and then about 50 acres to finish up on another one. So, if all goes well, we should have corn wrapped up by Sunday, and it's just phenomenal weather. It's supposed to be 19 or 20 degrees on Monday, so if we finish up corn in a t-shirt, that hasn't happened in a long, long time. So I think everyone's trying to take advantage of this beautiful fall weather here in November, because if you live in Ontario, you realize that this is a gift and it can change quite quickly, and you got to get as much work done as you can before it goes for a crap. So that's what we're all about. We're hammered down on the corn with the dream team, with Sandi and Jess. So I'll flip you around, you get to see what I look at for a bit, and the moisture's really dropped in the corn, which is good, so it's going through the dryer really quick. The dryer actually ran out of wet corn at 3:30 this morning, so it's good to see it going through nice and quick, so we'll get done.
On this field, we don't have much more to go. Dad is doing like the side headland thing, I don't know. And yeah, We're excited to have this farm out. This is probably one of our not so good farms that Dad has hated looking at all year. So as you can imagine, this probably feels pretty good to get off and pretend it never happened. Anyways, I'm gonna get back because he's gonna need me to unload again. Look at him come in. Wow. Okay, bye.
Well, we're nicely into the evening. We finished off that field. It yielded not as bad as it was looking at the beginning, but still not near as good as that farm should run. It's a good piece of ground, but we're thinking we've been nipped a few years, I think, getting manure out. So I'm wondering if it's just starting to show a lack of fertility. But I'm sure Mark will speak a little more to that. I think we can probably fit another 15 acres in the wet bin right now before my alarms start going off. So we are opening up our second last field, so that's pretty exciting. Now, we have a little spot opened up because Ethan took corn silage out of that. Oh my gosh, it was already 2 months ago, just about. It was like a month and a half ago he took corn silage for the sheep off. So we're back into that field, and hopefully it will run fairly decent. It was, I think, planted in April was our second field planted. So longer day corn, and it seems to do. Our April planted corn typically does quite well.
It's pretty sunset tonight.
All right, here we go. As you can see, I done goofed, and last night in the dark I realized not once, not twice, but three times I left wagon doors open yesterday. And last night in the dark was the worst one, of course, because we didn't see it. So I'm on cleanup duty first thing this morning, but it is a lovely sunny day. We're on our second last field. We got, I think Mark said we got about 18 acres done last night. So that's kind of cool. We got it kind of a little more opened up. This field's running a little better too, which is nice and very dry. So I think I talked about that yesterday. All right, let's clean up the mess we made, shall we?
Day three of corn harvest. Well, not actually, it's like, I don't know. But, got some bad news. We just broke the header. Last night, we changed the depth of it. Not much, but I guess it's enough that it kind of got wonky when he was just using it, and the three cones, I think, dug into the ground. I can kind of see it right now. They dug into the ground, and then they like went like this. So now they're just like hanging. So it's not a good sign. Dad has had a rough day so far. First, he chipped his tooth, which is a whole nother story. Second one, he ruined his pair of pants, which he was really sad about. And third thing, or actually, yeah, third thing, he dropped a whole thing of pop on his lap when we were at Wendy's. And fourth thing is we broke the header. So today is just, today is our day. It's like a mom day right now.
Just sneaked in here quick. We're having some issues in the field. Pretty bad issues. I'll keep you up to date with that in a sec. But my ewe got up all by herself today. Granted, she still looks sad, but she's got more strength in that leg. So really glad I gave her some calcium. So I just treated her again. I gave her calcium, drenched her with glucose. And yeah, and she peed again. So she's hydrated. So we're doing all we can do for now. But yeah, it was nice to see her standing when I got in here anyway. Small victories. All right, I gotta go. Don't tell anyone I do this. Never been more happy to have a day done as I am for this day to be complete. If I could title today, it would be Mark's Series of Unfortunate Events. Jess's tractor's been putting up codes like, I'm gonna get this wrong, like hydraulic filter or something, and it loses power and it like throttles the tractor right down, and she has to like turn off the tractor, turn on the tractor, and if that doesn't work, Mark has to disconnect the battery. So it's just, so that was the one thing. Mark went and got filters. While he was trying to get that off, I think a wrench slipped and hit him in the mouth or the chin, and then he thought he cracked a tooth or chipped a tooth. I think he spilled oil all on his pants, and then we went to Wendy's drive-thru for lunch, and the whole pop container spilt. One of the pops spilt outside, one was spilt right in the front. At his feet, so that was fun. And then our combine did a little bit of a nosedive, so now we are probably on a mission first thing in the morning to find a few new cones for our header. Anyways, I'm gonna go see what they're up to. I think they just pulled in.
Bad when they're all on the ground. How's the tooth?
My mouth is sore.
Is it? Is it from the your chin though, or is it your tooth?
My chin's a little sore.
Soon you get to use that.
Yeah, it'll be full of empty beer cans.